我是悠悠中文的薇薇。
I'm Wei Wei with YoYo Chinese. Today, we'll learn a super important concept in Chinese, measure words, and the most important one you should know. Make sure you click like and follow us here to stay up to date on our new videos. Also, if you don't know how to count to 10 in Chinese, check out our free lesson on this on Unit 2 of our beginner course. You can watch the video and download the PDF to better follow along during this video. Our first word is a measure word. We use measure word in English like one cup of coffee or a piece of cake, but we don't always use them. For instance, in the phrase one person. Well, in Chinese, we nearly all instances you will use a measure word in between the number and the noun. Let's learn one of the most common measure words in Chinese. Ge is the measure word for people and many different things. There are many other measure words, but if you don't know them or forget them, just use ge. It's sort of like a backup measure word. Now, one in Chinese is yi. It's just one horizontal line, so pretty easy to remember. Now let's put it together with ge. To say one, when used with a noun, it's 一个. Say with me. 一个.一个. Please note, E is a special character because it actually changes to the second tone when it's followed by a fourth tone character. So when used with 个, we pronounce the phrase as 一个. We cover the tone changes for E and the use of 个 and other measure words in depth in the paid content for our beginner course. So if you'd like to learn more, feel free to check the course out. All right, how would you say one person in Chinese? It's 一个人,一个人. Good. The next word we'll cover today is 是, meaning thing or matter. It's used for abstract things, not like a tangible item you can see. Did you notice? 是, matter, has the same pronunciation as the word 是, to be, that we've learned before. Just like English, you'll know which is being used based on the context. Say it with me. 是, 是, 很好. So, now we can also say a matter, right? How do you say that? It's 一个事. Good. Let's put all the words we learned this week together and make a new sentence. Let's listen to this sentence first.
因为我觉得学中文是一个很有意思的事.
That's a long sentence, right? Don't worry. Let's break it down a little. First, we have the phrase
因为我觉得学中文是.
What do you think that means? Because I think studying Chinese is. Now how about this last part?
一个很有意思的事.
We know 一个事 is a thing or a matter, and 很有意思 is interesting. But why is there a 的 in here? Well, when we're using an adjective to describe a noun, and the adjective is more than one syllable, we need to put a 的 in between the adjective and the noun. So it's 一个很有意思的事, an interesting thing. We cover this rule in more details in our intermediate course. So if you own the course, be sure to check out Unit 8 when we discuss this. All right, what does this full sentence mean?
因为我觉得学中文是一个很有意思的事。
Because I think studying Chinese is an interesting thing.
很好。
I know in English, we just say because I think studying Chinese is interesting. But Chinese people love to use 是 in phrases like this. So do try to get familiar with it. Say the full sentence together with me. Ready?
因为我觉得学中文是一个很有意思的事。
One more time.
因为我觉得学中文是一个很有意思的事。很好.
That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out YoYo Chinese for more learning resources for helping you learning Mandarin. See you next time.